Hey everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Have you had a bad day recently and you feel like nothing is working out in your life and you feel like whatever you're trying to do is ending up in a failure? Before you give up and spend your days dejected, spend a few minutes knowing about Dhamodbhava and how life played a cruel game with it. I'm sure you must be wondering who Dhamodbhava is. So let's get started. Long ago, even before Mahabharata, there lived an asura named Dhamodbhava. He wanted to become immortal, so he prayed to Surya, the sun god. Surya was pleased by his penance and appeared before him. Dhamodbhava asked Surya to make him immortal. But Surya offered him to ask anything other than immortality, because he believed anything or anyone in this planet would eventually die. Dhamodbhava thought of gaining immortality in a different way and came up with a request. He will be given 1,000 armors and 1,000 kundalas, and while each armor breaks, another one would reappear. He will be given 1,000 lives. While he is reborn again, he would be getting one armor and one kundala at a time. In order for someone to be eligible to kill him, they should have meditated to Lord Shiva for 1,000 years. And if someone meditates and succeeds to kill him, they would eventually die when the armor breaks. Surya was horribly worried because he believed Dhamodbhava had performed a very powerful penance and deserves the entire boon he had asked for. Surya was also worried because he would not use this for the power of good. Having no choice in this matter, Surya granted Dhamodbhava the boon. Immediately after receiving the boon, Dhamodbhava started wreaking havoc on people. People started getting scared to fight against him. Anyone who came his way was crushed by him. People started calling him Sahasrakavacha. It was around this time that the king Daksha got one of his daughters, Murti, married to Dharma, one of the mindful sons of Lord Brahma. Murti was well aware of Sahasrakavacha and wanted to put an end to his menace. So she prayed to Lord Vishnu to come down and help people. Lord Vishnu was pleased by her penance and blessed her with not just one child, but twins, Nara and Narayana. Nara and Narayana grew up in an ashram surrounded by forest. They enjoyed praying to Lord Shiva. They learned warfare and shared a great bonding, and they were inseparable. As time went on, Sahasrakavacha started attacking forests around Badrinath, where Nara and Narayana were staying. While Narayana was meditating, Nara went and challenged Sahasrakavacha for a fight. Sahasrakavacha looked into the calm eyes of Nara, and fear started building inside him ever since he received the boon. And while fighting started, Sahasrakavacha was astounded. He realized they were powerful. Nara got the power from the penance of his brother Narayana. And when Sahasrakavacha's first armor broke, Nara dropped dead. As per his wish, whoever breaks his armor would die, as a result of which Nara dropped dead. And Narayana came running towards him, and by his years of penance and pleasing Lord Shiva, he had gained Mahamrityunjaya Mantra, a mantra which would bring back the dead to life. And now, Narayana started fighting while Nara meditated. When Sahasrakavacha's second armor broke, Narayana dropped dead, and Nara came back and revived. This went on until 999 armors were broken. And sooner, Sahasrakavacha realized that the two brothers were undefeatable and ran back to a refugee with Surya. When Nara and Narayana approached Surya to give him up, Surya did not, because he was protecting his devotee. Nara cursed Surya to be reborn as a human. All this happened at the end of Treta Yuga. Immediately after Surya refused to fight Sahasrakavacha, Treta Yuga ended. To fulfill the promise of destroying Sahasrakavacha, Nara and Narayana were reborn this time as Krishna and Arjuna. Dhamodbhava and Surya were together born as Karna, the eldest son of Kunti. Karna was born with one of his armors as a natural protection. the one which is last of Sahasrakavacha. Due to the sins he had committed in his previous life, he had to pay back for all the evil things in the present life and to take part in all the evil things Duryodhana did. But Surya was inside him. Surya made him brave, powerful and charitable. So Karna was a hero as well. While Karna was abandoned by his own mother, he was refused to learn warfare because he was a charitable son. He even outshone Arjuna during their training, but was shooed away like a dog by Dronacharya. He won Draupadi's heart well before Arjuna at the wedding, but he was brutally rejected, even after he possessed all the qualities Draupadi desired for. He got cursed by a Brahmin while he was practicing archery and accidentally killed a cow. He held the small child and got cursed by Mother Earth. He was not allowed to fight because Bhishma believed he will not fight against a warrior who is not a Kshatriya. He was pleaded by Kunti not to kill Pandavas even at the cost of his life. He gave away his enchanted armor to Lord Indra wholeheartedly, even at the cost of his life, even while he knew it was a trap. On the day, Arjuna faced Karna. Arjuna's chariot wheel was stuck in mud, and Karna stopped fighting because it was not fair. Krishna and Arjuna managed to free the chariot wheel from mud and the fighting resumed. And while fighting resumed, Karna's chariot wheel was stuck in mud, and all the curses followed. He forgot the incantations of the divine weapons, and Arjuna killed Karna while he was most vulnerable. All his life, Karna was ridiculed, shamed and humiliated, not just by other characters but the fate itself. But he never stopped learning and never stopped fighting, and he never stopped being loyal to his friend Duryodhana. And he never refused to stand up for what he believed in. And most importantly, he never stopped giving. He gave away all his valuables even while he knew how cruel the fate was. So, if you think if you had a bad day and feel like nothing is working out just the way you want it to be, take a heart from Karna's story and face it nonetheless, without fear of failure and without interruption of learning. Because in real life, fate does seem to be real and life unfair. But what it matters at the end of the day and at the end of the time is how you evolve out of uncertainties and difficulties in life. Weather the storm and live your life with humility, dignity and generosity, just like Karna did.